degree from a premier institution should be satisfied.
Takeaways would be understanding of business is very much essential to land up in the role of head HR.
One is a good blend of understanding about business and also about HR. So that's one takeaway from this entire interaction. The other takeaway that we just got is you don't need to be very well qualified and all that. Firstly, you need to be very good human being to be an HR person. So I think that's a great qualification to have. And the other three attributes that's required is being an influencer, being empathetic, and last but not the least, being discreet. So these three attributes actually are the ingredients or the DNA for a great HR guy.
Situation with, I think, hundreds and thousands of employees in your organization, how digitally you can connect, influence people, that's the key going forward.
Points which have already been taken. Yes, we understood one thing: behavioral attributes overweigh compared to the technical strengths. So if we are really good in terms of our behavioral attributes, probably that will take probably faster and much smoother going up the ladder.
Aligning with the business, understanding the business, and then you have to gel with the business people in the sense, what is the requirement of the business, you have to understand, and you have to be with the part of the team. Business team, not just a standalone team of HR. That is the key focus the HR professionals should do. The second speaker, HR head, who spoke about what are the mechanisms, challenges faced by him, and then how to overcome all that. But today's context, what he told is that what is expected to get immediate results. Not just waiting for nobody likes delay, procrastination, and other things. So they want results immediately. Immediate results. The HR professional should be alert and be proactive, and also get results in terms of talent acquisition or giving solution to the business in terms of getting the talent record, right talent record for the organization. These are the key learnings in our group. What we have learned, and also he shared with us what are all the challenges he came across, and then the second speaker spoke about the various acquisition mergers and other thing, integration of HR, and what are the challenges faced in integrating in the challenge new environment of integration with the, you know, between one organization to the other, this kind of stuff he came across. Thank you very much.
Takeaway in our group was, you know, about talent management, you know, how you manage your people. And the key takeaway was that make your employees owners of business and make them stakeholders in your organization. That's the best way to manage your talent.
And there's also hope for some of us.
That was a very new, very important thing. He spoke about adding to what this group was telling, bringing the stakeholders onto the, you know, into the pitching. So he talked about bringing the entrepreneurial spirit amongst being a HR himself, HR head. He has brought, he's developing business and he has brought it down to the grassroots levels. So that was a very awesome learning for us. And apart from that, we learned a lot, I think a lot of learnings, and how coaching also could become one of the key elements to bring in transformation. Thank you.
I came with the thought that once a cleaner, always a cleaner. That's what I do for my living. But I also realized that there's a lot of organizations out there which is willing to risk people beyond you know, certain functions, and really also encourage HR professionals. So I think it really feels great that there is a lot of positive momentum out there in the mindset of people. At least I have changed in the thought of going there. Thank you. That's great.
Having a lot of students from Community Institute of Management. They have got a fundamental doubt whether they should pursue a career in HR. they have found that, you know, finance, sales and marketing have a lot of scope for growth. So we were elaborating on that. Let us hear what they feel.
So just asked if HR can be pursued as a career. So the thing is, personally speaking, I haven't decided on direct to it, and I'm not keen on HR. Though I'm not keen on HR, I keep mentioned in the because HR is something to do with one of the mysterious things, the human mind. It's more of understanding the behavior of the group or understanding the behavior of one's own self. So once he keeps updating us on this. So it's more of understanding how an organization works, and it's more dependent on managing the people, and which is most important. Though my electors finance and marketing, if there's an HR seminar, I do prefer to attend HR seminars. Though I do my elective, might not be HR, I don't know.
Thank you.
Usually what happens, a lot of the audience have questions that they would like to ask, but very few actually get an opportunity to ask those questions. Whereas when you break up into small groups like this, one, it's pretty informal, you don't feel nervous about asking a question, and probably because we've got so many HR heads here in the room to be in each group, I think a lot more learning actually happens by interaction, question and answer, than if one person, I mean, typically you would have guys coming with slides. So, good format, thank you.
About what each of the HR heads shared with you, right? That his synthesis is very helpful. Would like to understand, personally speaking, for each one of you as participants, before you walk into this room to now, what is the one key takeaway or new learning that you are taking away? Either you're going to implement it, or it's something that new personally that you've learned.
I was an HR guy and now an entrepreneur, so I asked a question which I could face in the future, and I have faced previously also, which is basically when you ask people to leave the organization. So how to keep the people who are in the system still motivated and not apply for a job? And incidentally, I currently run a job portal which gives jobs also. So, still try to retain people. So, I somewhere in HR, I was also told to hide information, don't reveal everything. Today I got a different take, that be honest in such junctures. I mean, go out there and tell that, we are shutting down this unit, and, because business is not happening, and tell the other folks, even though this is not happening, we'll make it up in the other unit. I mean, be honest, that's where the trust is, the biggest word which the gentleman used. So this is one key takeaway. And along with that, another question which I asked was, what if I fail in my, I failed twice previously in my two entrepreneurial stint after being in HR. So I thought, if I fail again, what, will you hire me? So the gentleman was kind enough to tell me, maybe I'll definitely look at your proposition. So these are the two takeaways.
In digital and e-commerce, fail entrepreneurs are hot commodity.
Into education. So before I come here, I was under an impression out of all the education institutions that HRs, the corporates, consider only those government certified bodies only, they'll recruit all these kind of stuff. And I got to know from sir that HRs look out for those who are having enough knowledge, caliber, not just qualification is not just the matter and all. Literally that gave me a lot of confidence to take over my organization to the next level. And thank you so much for providing this opportunity for me to interact. And thanks a lot, MHRD. Thank you so much.
This is very useful what Vijay said. It's a very powerful thing for a recruiter, actually hard thing for head HR. Be discreet. To the level of discretion is also don't tell your wife at home or spouse at home what you do as a head HR. That's a big thing. I think thanks, Vijay, for sharing. I think all of you agree because, there's something that you can't share at home. That's how discreet a head HR is. Okay? Don't get your life partners to influence you, or don't even share that. That's the biggest thing I've learned. Thank you so much.
Everybody, I'm Soumya. If you ask me about the learning, when I entered here and when the discussion started, till now, the learning part is managed as a child standing in front of an entire ocean. So it's like what I have been doing till now. I work as an HR, but it's way lot more to go actually. I'm just a child standing, just in front of the ocean, and the journey begins here. That's what I could learn. And the takeaway is from the two HR leaders that I could interact in our group, from Anuja I could learn is, I do not know how much am I going to implement this, to be honest, because I've just started. The learning is, be a business in HR and maybe the minutest of things, starting from you create 1,000 compensation letters for your employees and then your boss comes and says, sorry, the stapling is not correct, can you please change the entire process? And how much irritated you are, whatever it is, you need to do the entire process again because that is what is right. So how much ever it takes, what matters is you do it right at the end of the day. So that's one learning which I'll definitely keep in mind. From Anand, what I could learn is, be your own value system. The thing is, people may say anything. Till now what I was doing is, okay, I have a certain parameter to go ahead and measure a person. Beyond that, it's the senior management who will be taking the decision, even if my decision may not be agreeable to them. But here what I could learn is, if you feel you are as an HR, there is something very important required for an HR personnel, because that is where it will lead you to success. You may be demotivated, people may say different things, but stick to what is right and it will take you way ahead. That I could learn, so definitely try to implement, but probably slowly and steadily it will come into picture. So it was a really good session with everyone amongst you and with so many top-notch people sitting over here with freshers as well. It's a great experience. A bit nervous though, but yes, it was a pleasure being amongst all of you. Thank you so much.
Panel discussion in the last HRD sessions.
So I was attending diligently all the month program, but some months I got bored because all panel discussion, they will bring out their own perspective and they will speak about their own organization, all those things. So like that. But it, depending upon the topic interest, I used to attend. But today's session is ultimately very innovative. So HR professional should be innovative. That gives the message today's session, because it is altogether bringing different perspective from a group perspective also brought in into the session, which is totally different from all these months what we had panel discussion. So innovation is the key message which I take, that HR professionals should be very innovative, and this today's program is very innovative because different perspective from different speakers.
So my question was, I mean, have you supplied to any particular manufacturer in these JSC
door? You know, the idea of how do you get to the top leadership position in HR? Some are in different places. Some people are in Bangalore, some are in Chennai, some are in Kolkata, and some are in... How do these people get to Delhi? Now, clearly the answer is different for every individual. But let me share three or four things which emerged as common themes at these questions, on which some generic principles can be applied. So one question, couple of questions which were quite common were, how do you make the choice around one, industry domain, and second, functional expertise as you go through your career? So a very simple short answer on that, again, it could vary depending on situation, but on industry domain, what we have seen is that variety is not bad. In general, for leadership recruiting, people do